AI is already doing some great things, and the best is yet to come. But with this greatness comes risk. Risk that the system will do the wrong thing, give incorrect answers, and expose the organization to reputational and business damage. How can you reduce AI risk? Well, with a strong governance and security capability. Unfortunately, according to the 2025 IBM Cost of a Data Breach report, 63% of organizations had no governance policy in place. These two areas, governance and security, have some overlap, but mostly complement each other in important ways. In this video, we'll take a look at what these are and how you can leverage them to reduce AI risk. Okay, let's take a look at the problem space. Get that out of the way. First of all, we're going to look at compliance issues. So in theory, you should have a governance policy for AI and you should have a security policy for AI. Now, who are the primary stakeholders that are really involved with this? Well, when it comes to the governance part, it's probably going to be the chief risk officer. That's not the only person that's going to care, but they may be the primary person that cares. Versus from a security standpoint, it's more likely to be the chief information security officer. Again, both of these roles could care about this, but that's who might be the lead and the primary in these. Next thing we're going to take a look at, in terms of what the AI does, what are our particular concerns? From a governance standpoint, we want to make sure that the thing is responsible, that it's not doing things that put us in a bad light or put our users in a bad light or in a bad situation. We want to make sure that our AI is explainable, that it doesn't just make up stuff, the stuff it tells is in fact reliable. And a big part of that involves documentation and source attribution. We want to make sure that we can trace all of this stuff back and therefore make it more trustworthy. Now, from a security standpoint, we're looking at vulnerabilities that might exist within the AI system itself, where someone's trying to attack the system. We also are going to be concerned about things like shadow AI, that someone created some AI instance without approval, without authorization, yet this thing is out there running, and we might want to make sure that it's locked down because it might be a source of data leaks. Now, in terms of the cause of some of the issues that we might be trying to guard against with a governance policy and a security policy, I would say in general, and this is a big generalization because there's definitely going to be exceptions to this, but think of it this way, that the cause that we're really guarding against in a governance case is really self-inflicted wounds. This is where we used a bad model, we pulled it from a bad source, the model wasn't trained properly, the ingredients that went into the cake, as it were not the right ones, they weren't pure. And the result of this is probably unintentional. So we did all of this, we didn't mean to make a big mess, but we did. So we're trying to guard against that. We're looking at things like misalignments and policy violations and ethical lapses. We want to make sure those don't occur, and that's the realm of governance. Now, on the security side, what are we going to be caring about? Well, in this case, the damage and the cause of this is more done externally or by others. So self-inflicted versus others inflicted. And in this case, it could be internal, bad insiders who are doing something that they really shouldn't be doing, or it could be an external person who's attacking the system. Either one of those. But in these cases, it's more intentional. Someone is trying to break the system. That's what the security policy is really concerned with. Now let's take a look at the damage that can occur in these cases. So, if first of all, from a governance standpoint, we're looking at things like HAP. Hate, abuse, and profanity. We want to make sure that our system doesn't say really outrageous things that insult our users. We want to make sure that it is fair, it's unbiased. It doesn't bias toward or against any particular information or population. We want to make sure that the model doesn't drift. It started off true, but now it's getting a little more untrue as it starts learning more and more things, so we want to make sure that it's still solid. We're looking at issues like intellectual property. Is someone able to steal our intellectual property through this? And also important is our model trained on intellectual property that we didn't actually have rights to use? In other words, it might be copyrighted material, and then when our model learned on that, it starts using that, and now we're subject to a lawsuit. That'd be a bad thing. Hallucinations. We want to make sure that it's not just making up answers. that they need to be grounded in truth, and the reputation of our organization. We want to make sure that the AI, which is representing us, is doing it in a way that we would approve of. Now, on the security side, what are we looking at here? Well, you've heard me, if you've seen videos, I talk about this thing called the CIA triad, where we're looking at confidentiality, integrity, and availability. Those are the three things that we're about in every security case. Those are the things that we're trying to make sure we get right. So confidentiality, we want to make sure that, for instance, the system doesn't exfiltrate. It doesn't send sensitive information outside of our system so that other people can access it that aren't approved to do that. We want to make sure that the system, from an integrity standpoint, cannot be manipulated, that someone can't figure out how to make the system do other things that we don't intend it to do, that it gives bad answers, the data has been poisoned, things like that. And then finally, we want to make sure that it's available, that someone can't do a denial of service attack against the system and therefore make it not available for the people who need it. All of these things ultimately then feed into this idea of risk. Different kinds of risk and different kinds of policies related, but it's all about AI risk. So now we've taken a look at those risks, let's take a look at what we need to do about them. Well, one of the things is we're going to need controls in place. Controls are the things that let us control what's happening with the system. So some of the things we'll look at on the governance side is we want to have a set of rules that we have spelled out. We want to make sure that we're following them, that we've put those into policies that are well understood, and we're finding a lot of organizations don't do that and have not had that. It's pretty hard to know if you're succeeding if you've never even defined where the finish line exists. We need accountability structures. Who's responsible for this? And who's responsible for which parts of it? On the security side, we're looking at different things. We're trying to do prevention, detection, and response. That is, I want to be able to make sure that, to the extent possible, the system is not vulnerable to begin with, and then be able to find out when it is, when it's under attack, and then what we're supposed to do about it. So prevention, detection, and response. Now, with our models, what specifically do we need to do from a governance standpoint? Well, we want to make sure that they're trained properly. We need to know what the sources are so that that information is what we intend it to be. If you use bad sources, you get bad data and bad responses out of your AI. We need to know the lineage of the model. Most organizations are not going to create their own models, but if they do, they need to be able to know where did the ingredients come from. If I go to an open source model repository, where did I get it? Do I have the latest and greatest and authentic version, or do I have some illicit copy that somebody's made, some bogus version of it? And how many, who's touched it along the way? That's the lineage. We want to be able to see all of that. We need an acceptable use policy. What are the things that we're okay with our AI doing, and what are we not okay with it doing? And how do we want employees to understand their use of that? And as I mentioned before, IP risk. If we're going to be creating models, or even if we're going to take a model and train it with our information, we need to make sure that it's in fact our information that we have rights to. So those are all things that we would look at in terms of model and governance of those. On the security side, well, again, we're thinking about an attacker, something other than us that is coming in. And what is the number one attack type that we're concerned with, especially with generative AI? It's prompt injections. These are things where people are basically socially engineering our AI, giving it instructions to override its original instructions, and then having it do something that we didn't intend it to do. So I need to have protections against that. I need to have protections against unauthorized access. These are going to be bigger issues as we move toward agentic AI as well. I want to make sure that that agent that has autonomy isn't going to just go off and do something really crazy, because we're giving it a lot of power to do certain things. So unauthorized access, we don't want to allow that. We need to do penetration testing of these models. We bring them in, we need to find out if they're vulnerable to these types of attacks or not, and many, many more. Prompt injections, there's more of those than you can dream up. So we need tools that are going to be able to do automated prompt injection testing. We're also looking at a thing we call posture management to make sure that the system hasn't been misconfigured in a way that allows exposure of information that is sensitive to us. So those are some of the things that we're looking at from a governance perspective and from a security perspective. Okay, so now we've taken a look at the risks and some of the controls and things like that that we need in place. Now let's take a look at a solution framework that implements all of that. So instead of thinking of governance and security for AI as separate, kind of interlinked and overlapping rings, in fact, we could come up with a more integrated solution where we have layers of protection against the different types of threats that we're trying to deal with. So for instance, at the center is our AI that we're trying to protect. Then a ring around that of protection, that's our governance layer. And in this case, I'm going to do discovery and management of AI use cases. Those are the things that if I don't define what those are, I won't know if I've achieved the outcomes I intend or not. So I want to be able to define what those are right up front. I need to be able to do model management. So I've got a whole bunch of models. How do I make sure that they're doing what I intend? How do I know where they came from? All of those kinds of things. I need to do risk management. I need to be able to figure out what the risks are, quantify them to the extent possible, and at least expose what those are so we can map those and try to address those as we recognize them. I need to be able to monitor and check the performance of this system. It won't do any good if it's taking a month in order to get an answer back. So that's also a part of these concerns. I'm also looking at compliance. I may be in an industry where I need to be able to do certain things that will get me in trouble. I need to avoid other things I need to do in order to perform due diligence. So I need to make sure that the compliance of the AI system is in line with what the expectations are. And ultimately, lifecycle management. Because this thing isn't just a set it and forget it. These things have life cycles. They begin, they move through certain levels of maturity, and then certain parts of it need to go away and other parts of it come on. So I need to have this more holistic view of what the system is. Now, around that layer, we add the security protections that are necessary. So one of the things I want to do here, I was talking about discovering AI use cases. How about we discover the AI models that are out there in our environment, especially the shadow AI that may be out there? And once I've discovered it, I need to do this thing we call AI security posture management. That is a way to guard against misconfigurations, to lock down and make sure that the security policy for a particular system is being followed, that if it's not supposed to have public-facing data, the public can't get to it, that there are strong access controls, encryption, and things like that that might need to be in place. And we want to make sure that all of these instances of AI that we just found are, in fact, complying with our security policy. I need to test these models, do pen testing and other types of model scanning to make sure that the models themselves have not been infected. Because if they've been infected, they might leak information out, or they might give us wrong information. Another thing that we have to look at is maybe install something that I'll call an AI firewall or an AI gateway that implements guardrails that looks for exfiltration cases. So this is something that you set up between the user and the AI. You put it there and that it sees all the prompts that are coming in and it looks to see if they conform to policy or not. If it looks like we're experiencing prompt injection, well, then we can block it right there at the firewall. If it looks like our system now has been tricked into leaking information, we can look at the information on the way back out and maybe redact it or block it entirely. So we can test for these things in the model, but then we also implement the protections in real time. I'm also going to look at a threat monitor. I need to be able to understand what things are happening to my system. If somebody just did a bunch of stuff through this firewall and now they're trying to violate different policies, maybe someone should be aware of that. And then ultimately, I want to be able to see all of this stuff. I need some sort of dashboard that visualizes that for me, that shows me in priority what are the critical vulnerabilities that I have in my system, who's trying to hack me, am I in compliance from a security standpoint against some of the things like the National Institute of Standards Risk Management Framework, other things like that. So this now, if you put all of these things together, you have what is really a much stronger solution than you would have if this was only by itself. So the way to think about this then is if we have AI and we add to it governance plus security, then if we do it right, we lower risk. And that's ultimately what we're trying to do.